Hello again guys, welcome to another Qpython tutorial. Now on today's video we're going to be talking about the if function. Now what the if function does is it checks if a condition is true, and if the condition is true it just runs a certain line of code. So if I were to say A is B, it checks if A is B, and if A is B it just runs a line of code. But if in the case A is not B, it does this code and do not really do anything, because since A is not B and you program Python to tell you that since A is B it should run a particular code, then it should run the code fine. But if A is not B, the code does not run. So basically guys, to use the if statement you simply use if. That's the function called. But before we do that, let's make a simple condition. Now let's say X is equal to, let's use the name Desmond. Now to use the if condition you simply come down here and say if X. Now when you're testing the if condition you do not say equal to, you simply use double equal to sign, because you're testing if it's true and you're no longer making a variable. Because when making variables you use just an equal to sign, but when testing if a variable or a condition is true you use double equal sign, and when making not equals to sign you simply use the exclamation mark and the equal to in that case. So since we're doing equal to, let's say equal to, yeah. So now once you've done that you simply use whatever you're trying to test. So if S is equals to Desmond, now add your colon at this part and go to the next line. And once you've gone to the next line you need to click on this button right here, click on it and it takes you a tab away. So once you're at that point you simply say print out whatever, let's say Desmond is a real man. Yeah, I'm a real man. So once you've done that you just click on the next line and save this, and since you've saved it you run your code. Now since Desmond is true it says Desmond is a real man. Now once you've done that you simply see that this code runs fine, because Desmond happens to be X, and since X is Desmond or X is this and this condition is true, this line of code runs. Now let's do another line of code and say this if let's say X is not equal to Desmond. In this case we're going to be saying different stuff so we can see the difference between both. So see if S is not equal to Desmond I want you to run this line of code, and so let's say print what should we print out, let's say I do not know who who the F you are, but you certainly ain't a real man. Yeah, so this is good. Yeah, so let's save this our code and just run it. Now let's see what it gives us. Desmond is a real man. This works the same because Desmond is still X. Now if I were to change this to done, let's say Desmond without the D, automatically it doesn't become Desmond. This line of code will run because X is no longer equal to Desmond. So let's see what it gives us. It says I do not know who the F you are, but you certainly ain't a real man. Of course he's not a real man if he's not Desmond. Okay, that's all for now guys. Basically this is the basics of print statement, and if you guys have any questions please feel free to comment on the section below. And thank you guys for watching this video. Please hit that like button and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.